time, we listened to the beautiful katha with Parvati Devi, wanting to do her chores and having her things to do. Parvati Devi decided that she will put her son to sleep to rest. Parvati Devi, accompanying her son, placing him to sleep, she napped him and leaving him all alone. As Parvati Devi started doing her chores, Parvati Devi, for one moment, she glanced back at the place where she left her son sleeping, and lo and behold, he was missing. He was not there. She started combing and looking through the entire house, the entire place, the entire Mount Kailash, for her son Ganesh, and she could not find him anywhere. Parvati Devi decided that she would take on a disguise, and so she took the form of a cat. And taking the form of the cat, Parvati Devi made her way to that place where she thought that her son would be. Lo and behold, her son Ganesh was playing with his friends and having a good time in the company of his friends. She tried her best not to be seen, but she was seen. The more we try to hide, is the faster we'll get catch. The more hard you try to hide, is the faster you'll be made out. And so Parvati Devi, trying to hide, the children saw. And of all the children to mock and to irritate and to laugh at, Lord Ganesh was laughing at the cat. He was laughing at the cat. His friends looked at him and they mocked him and they said, "Oh Lord Ganesh, do something to the cat." And he filled his trunk with air and he started blowing it. But the cat was so poised, the cat stood strong. And so Lord Ganesh, not having any satisfaction, his friends started to laugh at him. "You are the remover of all obstacles and the bestower of all successes and Pratama Pooj, and you are mighty, and you are the son of Lord Shiva, and you are the son of Shakti Devi herself, and you can't move a little cat." They started to laugh at him. It is so easy for us and so easy for the ordinary mind to look at people and laugh at them. Tonight, when you laugh at somebody, you have secured 10 people laughing at you in return. The blessing that will come out of you laughing at one person is 10 people will laugh at you in return. So the next time you want to laugh at somebody, think first. The next time you want to insult somebody, think first. Think first before you act. Lord Ganesh, not having any satisfaction and being pressured by his peers, what will he do? Lord Ganesh took his two fingers as though he was scorning the cat, and he lifted it by its tail and he started swinging it in the air. The cat started to cry, the cat started to scream with pain, and as the cat darted out of the clutches of Lord Ganesh, he grabbed hold of the cat again by its two ears and holding it and pulling it and tugging it. Lord Ganesh had no mercy. They laughed and they had a good time and they enjoyed what they were seeing. Sometimes we enjoy seeing our friends and our relatives and our own brothers and our own sisters and our own children in trouble. We enjoy that. We look at it and we take it for a show. And so, placing the cat down, the cat could hardly walk. The cat started making its way to its home. Lord Ganesh, after playing and enjoying the company of his friends, he too went home. But when he went home, what will he see? Lord Ganesh calling his mother, "Ma, Ma, Ma," he's calling. She answers as though she's in pain. He rushes to see her, and seeing her, he says, "Ma, tell me, who did this to you? Tell me, who has done this to you? I will discipline that person." And she looked at him and she said, "You know who did this to me? A little short fat boy who doesn't listen. He has an elephant head and he doesn't listen. Not even to his own mother." Children do not listen. Because if we listen carefully enough, we will understand what our parents they are trying to say. They do not say no when you ask for something because. But they say no really because. Have you given thought they might be saying no because they have no money? Have you given thought that they might be saying no because they genuinely cannot provide? Have you given thought that they might be saying no genuinely because they can't help? Or they can't do? Parvati Devi, she looked at Lord Ganesh. Lord Ganesh started to cry. He begged for forgiveness from his mother. But Lord Ganesh knows that if the Devi were to tell Lord Shiva, then he'll be in grave trouble. He goes himself to tell. He goes because he doesn't want Lord Shiva to hear from Parvati. He wants Lord Shiva to hear from himself. And he goes to his father. But looking for his father is missing. Sometimes during your whole lifetime, your father might be missing. You mightn't see him and you mightn't hear him. He gets up early in the morning and go to work and he comes back home late at night and the children don't even know they have a father. They can't remember what he looked like. He's so busy. But he is trying to provide wealth for his family. But he has forgotten to provide what he is really supposed to provide. Fatherly love and affection. Money is not everything. You die and money remains behind. But you die and memory lives on after you die. Living life memoriously is what is important. Living life meaningfully is what is important. And so, Lord Shiva had left Mount Kailash. And he was having this battle against the demonic forces. But having this battle, what will happen? Lord Shiva realized that the demons were very powerful. And he realized that he was losing the fight because he did not put God first. He did not think about Lord Ganesh, his own son. The rule doesn't apply only to you and to me. It applies even to Lord Shiva and the Devatas and the Devis. Because Lord Ganesh is Pratama Pooja, the first to be worshipped. And so, Lord Ganesh, Lord Shiva and the Ganas put their hands together. Om Gam Ganapataye Nama. They're able to win the battle and Lord Shiva comes back to Mount Kailash. Parvati Devi and Lord Shiva, tonight they're preparing for something. What are they preparing for? They have invited the saints and the sages. They have invited the devatas to come. And so preparing, what are they preparing for? The rishis, the munis, the devatas, the devis, they've all been invited to come to this place called Mount Kailash. And why have they been invited? Lord Shiva and Parvati, they're about to perform that sanskar known as the Yajnopavit sanskar. They're about now to give the Yajnopavit or the janeyu to Lord Ganesh as a child. Have you ever been invited to a janeyu ceremony? Have you ever been invited to that sanskar? It is one of the most beautiful ceremonies that we could attend. It somewhat reminds you of a wedding, a viva. Because the very same vidhi, more or less, is being used. Except for the Sunday evening. The Friday evening, you have the hardi ceremony and the smearing of the hardi. Just like when somebody is getting married. Have you ever gone to the janeyu ceremony? And so Parvati Devi and Bhagwan Shankar, they elated, they're happy. They can't wait for when this ceremony will take place. And so they have invited all of their special guests to come. This evening, nobody goes to the yagya, or nobody goes to the puja by guest. They go because they are a guest. They go because they are invited. And if you go because you are not invited, atithi devo, you are treated as though you are God coming to the yagya. Have you ever had puja or satsang or some event at home and somebody comes to your home begging? At that time, this evening before I left here, I sat in the car and I was already on my way out. And a man and his wife and a little child came. And the man looked at me and he says, Sitaram. I said to him, Sitaram. He said, can you give me some food, please? We are hungry. And so my child is hungry. Can you give me some food? And I said to him, no problem. Come, we will give you some food. And the food had just finished being cooked. And so I reversed my car down and I called out to one of my aunt and I said that, do not ask me a single question and do not question me. Take out some of that food and give it to this family and let them eat anything they want and any amount they want. And when they're about to leave, pack a bag with something so that when they go home, they'll be able to cook and they'll be able to be happy. The ordinary mind will say, well, we just finished cooking the food. Nobody blessed the food as yet. The ordinary mind will say, well, we made that food for the night. Let us give what we cooked at lunchtime. The ordinary mind will say, well, this food was not prepared for them. It is prepared for the guests that will come at night. Atithi devo bhava. We never know if that is God trying to test us. What is the use? We have a huge bowl of rice in our cupboard. And tonight, after you eat, you will fold up your leaf consciously You know you could eat so much and you take so much. Fold up your leaf consciously and throw it into the dustbin when there is a man and his family who has no food. Wouldn't God be happy if we feed them? The people who really need. We go to the yagya and we go to the puja and we get the bottle of water. We open the bottle of water and we open the chobi and we take 2 sips and we lock it back and we throw it in the garbage. Do you all have any idea how much that cost? You only know when you have to buy it for 16 nights. Do not waste. Do not throw away. Close back your lid and put your bottle in your bags. And when you go home, you have some water to drink. Water is life, you all know? The more water you drink, the more healthy you become. You all know? Like Sintra drinking water now. The more healthy you become. Do not waste. Do not throw away. Do you know in parts of the world there are people wishing that they could have 1 drop of water? We throw away and we waste. Tonight, the Devatas have been invited to come to this very special ceremony. And being invited, what will happen? Listen, it continues to tell us.
जिस घर में होता रह मेरा पात कह जपा उस घर की राक्षस कह मीती सभी का हस्तापन सभी का हरी कियो जय गणनाता जय श्री गणेशा जय गणनाता जय श्री गणेशा
सिंग विथ मी एवरीबॉडी
जय गणनाता जय श्री गणेशा जय गणनाता जय श्री गणेशा
ओ जय गणनाता जय श्री गणेशा जय गणनाता जय श्री गणेशा
सिंग विथ मी एवरीबॉडी हियर यू
जय गणनाता जय श्री गणेशा जय गणनाता जय श्री गणेशा
गणेश भगवान की जय All of the Devatas and all of the Devis and all of the Rishis, they were very beautifully dressed. And so wearing their beautiful chandan and wearing their beautiful malas and wearing all their beautiful accessories, they were all looking very beautiful. Have you ever had a particular outfit and you like to wear a particular chain with it? Have you ever had a particular outfit and you like to wear particular shoes with it? I never knew until I heard the girls at work saying, that you know you're well-dressed when your handbag and your shoes matching. They said then and only then, your handbag, your shoes and your lipstick must be matching. And then you know you are well-dressed. Is that true? Is that true? Oh, I'm seeing that they are saying yes. Handbag, shoe and lipstick must be the same color and then you're well-dressed. Oh God, we don't wear handbags. We don't wear lipstick and we get ready in 2 minutes. I don't know what you all have to do, really. I can't begin to understand what you have to do. My mother, when she has to go someplace, 1 hour before, her whole head in colors. I look at her and I say, God gave you straight hair for a reason. She said, well, I like to curl it for a reason. What is the reason? To keep me back? She says, no, to look good. Tonight, your hairstyle mightn't matter. Your lipstick definitely mightn't matter. Your handbag mightn't matter. But you see your heart? That is what matters. You see the love that comes from your heart? That is what matters. The love that you could give from your heart? That is what matters. The little good word that could come out of your mouth? That is what matters. The little motivation that you could give to somebody? That is what counts. And so, all of them beautifully dressed. What will happen? There are 3 rakshasas there are three demons. And these demons, they have bedecked themselves as well. They have dressed themselves very beautifully. And so they're wearing the chandan and they're wearing the mala. And they're wearing all of the accessories just like the devatas. And so wearing this, what will happen? Listen, it tells us.
देखते ने संसार की हालत क्या हो गए भगवान वो कितना बदल गया इंसान वो कितना बदल गया इंसान संसार की हालत क्या हो गए भगवान वो कितना बदल गया इंसान वो कितना बदल गया इंसान बदला चांद न बदला ना बदला ने आसमान वो कितना बदल गया इंसान वो कितना बदल गया इंसान ज्ञान चलते अज्ञान से जपो जपे को मेरा नाम स्मरण हो प्रसन्न उस जीवा के करो मैं पूरे काम
It says the three demons, they do not only take on the beautiful disguise, but the three demons, they were singing the beautiful praises of God, Bhagwan. They were singing the praises of Lord Shiva and Parvati, and they were even singing the praises of Lord Ganesh. Tonight I want to tell you, and I'm telling you from my heart, not everybody who sing your praises like you. Not everybody who sings your praises like you. I have learned that, and I learned that the hard way. Not everybody who says to you, you are nice, they really mean that. In their mind, they're saying you're nice to keep far from. Not everybody who says to you that you sing nice mean that they like what you sing. In their mind, they say your voice irritating. Not everybody who come up to you and say you're the best really mean that. Because they said to somebody else yesterday, they're the best. And they will say to somebody else tomorrow, they're the best. And so anybody they stand up very conveniently, that person is the best. Because they want to be the best in everybody's eyesight. I always say that a lion doesn't have to tell you how vicious it is. It is understood that the lion is vicious. True or not? The lion walking to Palmi's park here, well, I don't know about you, I was the first man run out of here. I'm not waiting to see what the lion will do. It could be anybody's pet, I really don't care. Because it is understood that the lion is vicious. It is understood that we will be the food of the lion. Tonight, you do not have to roar to express your greatness and your brilliance and your radiance to anybody. You do not have to prove your worth to anybody. There are many people who think you're worthless, you know, until you really have to help them. There are many people who think that life is a big competition and it's about who could have more money and who could have more status and who could have bigger house. I always say, you see bigger the house, bigger the headache. You see bigger the car, bigger the headache. The people who have the small house living happy like puppy, you know, the light bill is $100, yours is $2,000. Half of your pension gone in light bill alone. You're living for the rest of the month, not on pension, but on tension. You're wondering where you'll get food. You have a fridge upstairs and a fridge downstairs. Well, I only have one fridge where I live in. And if I want something and I'm upstairs, I'll walk downstairs and get it. Because it is not a competition. Life is not a competition. Life is not about how much we could have. but life is about how much we could give. Life is not about what we could get, but life is about what we could give, what we could do, how we could help. That is what life is about. Life is about is seva. We do not only sit here and preach, but we act, we do. They're sweeping, we sweep. They're making the parsad, we're turning. They're cooking the chana, we turn the pot. We don't know how to cook chana. I can't cook chana. But if I see the chana, I will go and take the double and turn. Because by doing that, I am expelling some of my pap, some of my sins. What do we do to expel our sins? We sit down and we order in, do this, and do that, and bring this, and bring that. You think you're the master chef. And you get master zero blessings. The hands that do, they're greater than the lips that pray. Always remember that. The hands that serve are greater than the lips that pray. You can't begin to imagine how much people come here every day. And they go in that kitchen. And nobody has to tell them what they have to do. Everybody knows what they have to do. Everybody knows what is required of them. And with no hesitation, they will go and they will do what they have to do. And at the end, when nighttime comes, everybody enjoys. Even the people who work, when they come, you would swear that they never did anything for the whole day. Because they do it with bhakti, with devotion. Anything you do from your heart with devotion, God will accept. But anything you do fussing and fretting, you get zero blessings for. I'm telling you that from my heart. Zero blessings for. I take the whole week off, you know, to help all you in the Ganesh Utsav. But every day you in the Indian Expo, you ain't helping Ganesh Utsav. You take time off to look after yourself. You didn't take time off to help. Well, I'll come for 1 hour and I had to pay my light bill, and I had to pay my phone bill, and I had to pay my water rate, and they go cut me off. You wait till they'll cut you off. It's 2018. It is called telebanking. Pick up your phone and call. Do it via your phone. Tonight, three demons take the form, they look, they appear like devatas, and they enter. And as the three demons enter, they're the ones who are singing, they're the ones who are praying, they're the ones who look divine, they're the ones who appear to be holy. Tonight, what makes us holy? What makes us holy? And what makes us divine? The three demons are the ones praying, chanting, appearing to be divine and holy. Only good people pray? Only good people pray? Hello? Only good people pray? To answer. Is the one who picking flowers every Sunday morning and going temple without fail? And you come by there and you say, lend me $5 now. I have no money to buy doubles. They say, huh? Me, I want $5 for myself. I take up $1 to throw in the RT. You're really throwing it in the RT. You ain't putting it in, you're throwing it. You say, I bring $1 to throw in the RT. The three demons are the ones who are praying the most. And they're the ones who appear to be most holy and most divine. And appearing like this, what will happen? They sat in the midst where they could see everything. Do you know there are some people that attend the function just to see? I go in, you know, because I want to see. I just want to see. And I sit in down where I could see everything and everybody. You have some people, they say, well, you know, I only come because I want to show my face. One of my cousins said that to me for my birthday. She said, I came, you know, for the prayers, and I really come tonight. Is your birthday? I come a little bit because I come to show my face. I said, well, you could have sent a picture. If it's your face you come to show, and you could have bring it up by me, I would have sit on it. And she started to laugh. She said, why will you sit on my picture? I said, because you didn't come here with good intentions. You came here to show your face, and nobody really want to see your face. Anytime you think you're going to prayers and you're doing God a favor, you're fooling yourself. Anytime you think that you're doing something in the name of God and you're doing God a favor, you're fooling yourself. God doesn't care about what you do, you know. God doesn't care about what you could do, you know. It is true, God, we could do everything that we could do. But whatever we do, we should do it without looking for fame and name and glory. You know, some people, if they move a chair, you have to tell them thanks, you know. Otherwise, you're in real trouble. I said to members of my group, I said to them, and I said with no apology, I said, you see, in this yagya and any yagya that we will host, we will never have something that is called a vote of thanks. We would never say thank you to anybody, but we will simply say God bless everybody. Because the man who did the smallest thing and the man who did the biggest thing, you don't know who will get the most blessing. You never know. The three demons took the disguise of holy people. And the three demons sat there chanting and praying, and they appeared to be divine. Not everything that glitters is. I want you to say that with me tonight. Not everything that glitters is. It might appear to be gold, but it's not gold. It looks like, it feels like, but it isn't. And so as the three demons entered, what will they do? They do something. Listen, it tells us. As the demons sat there, after 9 hours will pass, the ceremony was taking place, and the demons, they became frustrated, they became fed up. You ever go to a function and it's going on and on and on, and your belly going grr, 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 and you can't wait, all you're thinking about, well, if I can't get the food, give me some parsad now. You ever go to the function and ask the president, you eat down the whole bag of parsad and you can't eat no food? And the people say, come and eat now, and you say, give me 5 minutes, I'll come in now. It's because your whole stomach full with all the parsad, the only thing you didn't eat was the bag. You're so hungry. People go to prayers with all different kinds of intentions, you know. You all know? People go to puja with all different types of intention. Some go because they like the parsad. Some go because they like the food. Some go because they like the atmosphere. Some go because they like they will be on TV. Some go because they like the Baba. Some go because some friend said to them, come now, let me go. They had plans to go somewhere else, you know. And their friends say, oh God, come with me now. And they say, well, I'm only going, you know, I'm going because of you. The demons sat there for 9 hours, and they became agitated and aggravated. You ever go someplace or going to someplace and you become agitated and aggravated? Long drive coming down the road. And you say, when we go reach, boy? When we reach? Like auntie and her husband came all the way from Rio Claro this evening. That must be a long drive to come. When we go reach? How long again? And so, after sitting there for 9 hours, the demons, they decided that they will do something. But as they decided to act, then something happened. What will happen? Listen, it tells us. The demons, they were about to get up, they were about to move, they were about to go. And as the demons planned to get up and to move and to go, at that same time, all of the devatas were given the instruction to stand up. The devatas, they stood up, the rishis, they stood up. And all of them, they were given rice, aksha, rice. And this rice was colored red. Being given the red rice to hold in your hand, the mantras of benediction were being chanted. And so the rice was being showered on this child, Lord Ganesh. When we go to the yagya long ago, and the closing mantras were being chanted, all of the shrotas by the Bedi will come around the pandit who was reading, and they will massage the foot of the pandit. Have you ever seen that before? And the pandit from the Bedi, he will take his mango leaf with his water, and he'll walk through the entire place, everywhere, and he'll sprinkle the water. Shiva Hari, Shiva Ram. And sprinkling the water, he'll sprinkle the water everywhere. Blessing everybody, showering the Ashava. Long ago, at home, when you were doing the puja, when the pandit will chant the closing mantras, he'll take some rice grains and he'll shower it on the yajman, the people who were standing performing the puja. Now you say, Baba, don't throw tuma rice, eh? Tuma rice all over the place, it's hard to clean. So don't throw no rice. And then you say, well, you know, I can't sleep good. it have some spirit in your house. You know who is the spirit? You. Use your own spirit. Because when the man come and he's chanting his mantras and blessing the house, you fussing. You light the hawan kun and you're afraid that the smoke will black up the ceiling. God give you a house to live in, you know. It have people who have no house and they're dying to do a puja, and God give you a house. And you say, me, I want to my fire in the house now. It will black up the whole house. Baba, go easy on the fire. I just changed my curtain. My curtain new, it cost me a little money. Don't light too much fire. But if you tell me that, you're in real trouble. Because I'm making sure I smoke up the whole house before I leave. Tonight, what we give is what we will get. How we give is how we will get. The attitude in which we give is the attitude in which we will receive. And so this child, being showered with the rice, chanting the mantras of benediction, all the devatas, they were invited to put their hands together. And so as they placed their hands together and the mantras were being chanted, the three demons decided to act at that time. What will they do? The three demons deciding to act, this is what they do. They decided at that time that they will get up and they will act. You ever plan that in the middle of a prayer you have to leave? So you wait until everybody close their eye and then you sneak out. You ever do that before? You ever go to the funeral and you can't go to the cremation or to the burial? So the pundit say, well, all of those who want to view the body, now is your time to come. And you dash out. You say, you see me, let me run away now. Now is my time to run away. And when you go by your car, the Baba park behind you. You can't leave because he can't leave. You know, I had the privilege of doing this funeral one day for this man who lived alone. And he went to the side of his house where there was a tank. And he went with the hope of pulling some water to feed his parrots. And he took the bowl out of the cage and he closed back the cage and he went. And he got a heart attack right by the pipe and he died. And they found him, I think, days after. They found him. And they called and they said, Baba, we want you to do the funeral. I said, no problem, I will come. I never say no to a funeral. I don't even know the man. I don't even know what he looked like. I don't know anything. I didn't even know how the man died until I reached the funeral. And when I got there, it's a beautiful casket. And in the casket, there is a little square glass where you could look down inside and you could see the man. But the casket is closed. So when I got there and the ritual started, the boys from the funeral home said to me, Baba, we will open the box so that you'll put the pindas and thing in there. The family wants the pindas and thing in the box. I said, all right, no problem. Is it safe? They said to me, yes. He dead, he safe. I said, okay, no problem, open the box. We opened the box and we placed the flowers and we placed the malas and we did the ceremony, no smell or anything. Place the body in the hearse after the ceremony is done and they're ready to go. And I'm feeling for my car keys and I can't find it anywhere. I can't find my car keys anywhere. I search down the table, I search everywhere for the car key and no car key. I said to the man from the funeral home, I said, wait, don't leave yet. He said, what now, Pandit? We have all the documents, we are ready to go, the ceremony is done, they're waiting for us. I said, hold on, pull out that box from in there. He said, why? I said, you just do what I'm saying to do. I called the five boys. I said, this is an extra part of the ritual. Now is where you have to help me search. Baba, what are we searching for? I said, you don't ask any question. Just follow my instruction. Stand up here so nobody will see. Block me, block the hearse. And they pull out the box and the boys begin to search. You know my khaki was inside that box? The dead man, everybody's scorning my car key inside of there. And I have to hold the car key to start the car. The thing you scorn the most, God will teach you how not to scorn. The thing you don't want to do, God will teach you when you have to do it. The thing that you think you're not capable of doing, God will give you the strength to do. The thing that you think you will never be able to overcome, God will give you the courage to overcome that. And you will overcome it and you didn't even know or realize that you overcame. Tonight, the demons stood up and as the devatas clasped their hands and they started to pray, the demons approached the child. And approaching the child, They were not showering their ice creams. They were pelting it at him. And they were aiming for his eyes. You ever go to the beach and somebody throws sand on you and it goes straight in your eye? How does it feel? How does it feel? You look at them and you say, but that is not a joke, man. Sand in my eye. And they say, well, you're in the middle of the ocean. Go and wash your eye. So they were aiming at the eye of Lord Ganesh and pelting and throwing the rice. And pelting and throwing. What will happen? Something happens. Listen, it tells us. Lord Ganesh, while they were throwing the rice on him, he opened his hand and he was catching it. And catching it, he had rice grains in his hand. He chanted some mantras, and chanting these mantras, as everybody closed their eyes, Lord Ganesh used the rice that he had in his hand and he sprinkled it on the three demons. And the three demons, just by chanting that mantra, sprinkling that rice on the three demons, the three of them fell dead right in front of him. Don't you just wish you have some rice that you could chant a mantra on and treat on some people? Hello? When you're impressed, don't lie. Talk the truth. You're looking at me and, Baba, what are you saying? I'm saying the truth. The truth always sounds bad. The truth always sounds offensive. But the truth will always be the... You don't wish sometimes you had some rice and you could just sprinkle it on some people? Talk the truth. Lord Ganesh hearing you. Well, tonight, just as you wish that you could throw that rice on somebody, somebody wished they could throw rice on you too. I want to tell you that just as you are wishing bad for somebody, you could be how good, somebody will always criticize you. You could be how good, somebody will always condemn you. You could try how hard, somebody will always find a fault. And you would never be good enough. True or not? Is that true or not? Hello, is that true or not? Somebody will find something negative to say. You dress up, you know. You take your time and you well wrap your sari and put on your powder and your lipstick and you come out and your husband watch you and he say, Ivan Kalicharan, you're looking like you're going to play Olmas. And he say, why are you saying that? And he say, look at powder for soap. And he said, well, the room was a little dark. But he doesn't understand. Ladies put a little extra powder, so by the time they reach and they pat their powder, they have enough on. True or not, ladies? Tell your husband when you go home. Is that true? Hello, is that true? I only know because I know from my mother. What I know from my mother. She said, I put a little extra, so by the time I reach and I done sweat and thing and I pat it, I'll be good. Tonight, he sprinkles the rice on the three demons, and the three demons, they fall dead right in front of him. The rishis, the munis, the devatas, they open their eyes, and as they open their eyes and they see what is taking place, listen, it tells us. Parvati Devi, seeing what had happened, Parvati Devi immediately, she looks at her son and she says, your pious and noble action, son, forces me to give you a gift. We give our children gifts to motivate them. We give our children gifts to help them, to give them an incentive so that they could work hard and they can better themselves. True or not? We promise the child, if you come out first in test, I'll do this for you, or I'll give you that, or I'll take you to this place. Parvati, seeing what her son had done, Parvati immediately summons the lion upon which she rides, and she gives him it as a gift. You ever see how your son drives somebody else's car? And you realize he ain't crash it, so you decide to give him yours to drive. But he try out somebody else's own first, huh? Parvati, she gives this child the Singh, the lion. And so, Lord Brahma gave him a kamandal, a sacred jar filled with water. And so, Lord Brahma named him Pranaspate. Kubir, the god of wealth, gave to him a necklace of gems. Lord Varun gave to him a noose. And so the different devatas started to bless him with the different articles and instruments. One of the devatas gave to him, Parshuram gave to him a a hatchet and giving to him, they named him Parashuhasta, meaning the holder of the Parashu. And so all of the demons, hearing what had happened, the demons become even more furious. They become even more frightened. And so as Lord Ganesh has been blessed by the Devatas, what will happen? Something else is about to happen. Tomorrow evening, we would listen. Siddhi Vinayak Ganesha Bhagavan Ki Jai.